In the last lecture, we have seen that the neighborhood system is very much powerful and it can characterize the notion of topology. In this discussion, we'll start with how to describe the nearness of a point in a topological space with a subset of it. More precisely, let us begin with the topological space X. And A may be any subset of X. And we are going to call a point Y
is an accumulation point of A,
provided you take any open set U in X containing your Y, then just check at least one point X is available in A, which is different from Y in that one. That is what you are trying to check, which means a point Y in X is said to be an accumulation point. In fact, it can be called a limit point also, accumulation point of your set A, provided you take any open set containing Y, it should include a point other than Y from A. That is what the formal definition is. It actually gives you what are the nearing points to A. That is what we are observing usually. So, see, if you are looking at a subset A of a topological space X, and all points inside A, you are tempted to say that they are very near to A, obviously. But we need a little bit more, in the sense that topologically we have to determine how far away it is. So, we have to, whenever we are trying to say that some point is nearing to A or nearer to A, whenever, not only with A, you have to consider about whether it is an accumulation point also. That is, we are trying to look at. See, some examples will definitely give the notion well. See, look at what happens for the familiar examples. If I'm just looking at the discrete topology, for example, X, I will consider with the discrete topology. And try to check, are there any accumulation point for the set? For any set you can consider. So A may be any subset of X. Just start with any point Y. Can you call that, what kind of points Y are going to be called as the accumulation point of A? See, if you are working with a discrete space, singleton sets are open sets. But then what will happen is, that open set, if you are intersecting it with A, the only point is just singleton Y. It's not taking any point other than Y. So obviously, no subset is going to be having this property, which means any set you consider in a discrete topological space, no points are going to be accumulation points. But what happens for the other end? See, if you are considering it the indiscrete space, what is the situation? If X is an indiscrete space. Remember, an indiscrete space means only full X as well as empty set are going to be open sets, declared to be open sets. Now, let A may be any subset of X and take Y. If you want to check whether it is an accumulation point for A, what you need is, it will start with an open set. Open set means X should be there. That X should intersect Y with a point other than Y. So if your A contains more than Y, at least one element X, then obviously that point is going to be an accumulation point. So in the indiscrete space, Y is an accumulation point for any set A, provided A contains at least one point other than Y. Similarly, one can look at our familiar candidate real number system with its metric topology, usual topology. Then what happens? That also we can just see. If you are looking at the real numbers R with usual topology and look at some subsets. For example, let me consider an interval 1 to 4, an open bounded interval 1 to 4. If I'm just checking 2, 2 is my set under condition is 1 to 4, the interval 1 4. That's what I mean. I'm interested for looking at what are the accumulation points for this set. Now, if 2 is in concern, take any open sets containing 2. Certainly, it's going to interact with 1, 4, a point other than 2. So, which means 2 is an accumulation point. Nothing special with 2. Any point inside the set also going to be behaving like that. Any point x, you can work like that. So, all points in A are going to be accumulation points. But are there anything more? See, look at 1. 1 is not available in A. It is not sitting inside A. But still, you can check. You look at any open set containing 1 that also intersects with your set A other than a point 1, which means 1 is also an accumulation point. In a very similar way, we can argue with 4. So, not only the given A is having the accumulation points of A itself, 1 as well as for all 4 are also coming as accumulation points. In fact, one can see that no other points are going to be accumulation points. So, away from this, closed 1, 4 is going to be the set of accumulation points for this A. So, while discussing about the nearing points, some vague idea will come here. The set here, at least this is a very nice example and the metric topology is concerned. So, your expectations will be more visualizable. So, in this situation, what happens is A as well as the nearing. Here means just 1 and 4 are also included. You can approach the points from A. That is what it means from the metric sense and all. But nothing special about these examples. In fact, one can look at even in R with usual topology, one can look at Q, which is a good subset of R. One can determine what are all accumulation points. Any real number you take x, that is obviously going to be an accumulation point for Q. Why? Take any x, any open set U, certainly U must contain rationals different from x. It's obvious. Similarly, you can argue with irrationals too. Now, R with some other subset we can check about. Look at R with usual topology and let n be the subset of R, that is natural numbers. Natural numbers on R, they are going to be discrete, topology 1, 2, 3, etc. only. All that is what is n. So it is having discrete topology. Natural topology is discrete topology. So you are not going to get any accumulation point as we have discussed before. So this is the notion of limiting or accumulation points of a set in a topological space X. So what ideally comes as accumulation points to, we will just consider them as the new terminology using derived set. We'll just define them derived set. A derived set, see that ideally, if A is any subset of a topological space X, we call that the derived set is just a set which consists of all accumulation points. That is what we are trying to define it formally. So, A be any subset of X, the derived set of A, we will denote by A dash. Don't confuse it with complementation and all, we will use it A dash. This consists of all accumulation points of A inside. That's all. We will use this notation. So, once you know about the accumulation point A dash of a set A, A with A dash actually going to give you the nearing points. That is what you are trying to look now. So, a formal theorem, in fact, that set, that union is nothing other than that the closure. That is what the next theorem says. You take any subset A, and you look for A closure, that is by definition, A closure can be given as the smallest closed set containing A. So, look at A and or approachable points topologically with A. That is, A dash also has to be put inside. That is why the theorem is becoming natural. A closure is nothing other than that A adjoined with its derived set. That is what the whole closure is. So we will quickly look for the proof here. What you have to show that A closure is going to be A union A dash. First, we claim the following. A closure is A union A dash. So, A union A dash, A closure by definition is the smallest closure set containing A. First, we will observe that this is a closed set. A union A dash is a closed set. We wanted to prove that. So equivalently, its complement is going to be open. That is, X minus A union A dash. This is going to be an open set. To prove that this is an open set, we'll show that X minus A union A dash is a neighborhood of each of its points. That is another way of realizing. It's a neighborhood of each of its points. So this is the way what you are trying to prove it. So how to look for that thing? So on this set, you have to start with an element AY and you have to produce an open set pushing inside here. That is how you have to show that it is a neighborhood of each of its points. So let us begin with the point Y, which is available on the complement of A union A dash. This means that, say, Y is not available A as well as in A dash. So it is not going to be an accumulation point. That is the first observation. It is not an accumulation point. But that implies what? There exists some open set V which contains your Y. But it contains no point of A except possibly Y. Right? Just use the definition of an accumulation point. So there should exist an open set V containing Y, and that contains no point of A except possibly Y. Y may belong to that, but Y is not inside A. Remember that, right? Which implies A intersection V is going to be empty. A intersection V is empty. Now, what about A dash intersection V? So A has to do nothing with V, that is clear. Now, whether V will do something with A dash, that is the question. We will try to look at that. A dash intersection V is also going to be empty. Now, A dash intersection is how the behavior of a point inside there. Just start with a point Z in A dash intersection V, which implies what? V is an open set containing your Z, which is an accumulation point of A. So, Z is going to be an accumulation point of A, that is given. But it is inside V. What does it imply? But this implies what? V intersection your A is not going to be empty in that case, right? Once V intersection A is not going to be empty, that is obviously going to be a contradiction, which says your Y, generally speaking, your Y is inside V, but it is not touching A as well as A dash. So the moral is that if you are looking at A union A dash and you intersect with your open set V containing your Y, that is going to be empty, which implies your V should live inside the complement part X minus A union A dash. So what does it imply? any point y you have taken from here, that y, containing that y, a v is available which is sitting inside there. V is open. So this set is going to be an open set because it's a neighborhood of each of its points, which ideally says A union A dash ultimately a closed set. That is what we are aiming at. That was our claim. So A union A dash is a closed set. Now, we wanted to show that A union A dash is in fact equal to A dash. Obviously, A is sitting inside A union A dash. Right side is a union with A, which implies taking the closure on both sides, that also respects. But remember, this A union A dash is a closed set that you have just seen. So closure is same as that of the set. So this says this is same as that of A dash, which says A closure is a subset of A union A dash. So to prove the equality among these, just you have to prove the following: A union A dash, the one part only remains, is subset of A dash. Now again, see A union A dash subset of A closure. If you want to prove, the only non-trivial part is this part, that is A dash is sitting inside, that is the inside A closure, because A is always sitting inside A closure. This is what you have to look at. That is easy to observe. To prove that, start with Y in A dash. If your Y is not inside A closure, then what it says? Then it should be in the complement. This implies Y should be A closure complement. That is in the X minus A closure it has to do. But A closure is closed, so it's an open set. So you have an open set containing Y. But Y is an accumulation point of A, remember that. So what happens? It has to intersect. It is an accumulation point, right? So this X minus A closure, it lies on A closure complement, that is X minus A closure, has to intersect with A, has to be non-empty. But that's a contradiction, because A is completely sitting inside A closure, right? So this contradiction says that A dash is also inside A closure. Ultimately, it says that equality holds with A closure as well as A union A dash. That is how the theorem is proved. But it says that A closure actually consists of A adjoined with A dash. But a little bit more we can say if you are interested. As I mentioned before, topologically you are searching for the nearing points to A, which means topologically neighborhood system is very powerful in characterizing the notion. So just look at any neighborhood of Y, a point, and that actually meets A in a non-trivial manner, a non-vacuous manner, that is precisely A closure. Either it may be with the A condition or the A dash condition. So that comes as the next theorem. That also we'll check it. Any subset you consider, A, of a topological space X, then A closure is consisting of those points Y in X that every neighborhood of Y hits A non-vacuously. Some point should be inside in connection with E. So to show that, for that you just, so for the proof, you consider your B as a, define a set B by definition that every neighborhood of Y meets that. So if U is a neighborhood of Y, that should imply U intersection. So those y's such that, y is in X such that u belongs to neighborhood of Y, then that u should intersect A non-trivially. Some intersection should be there. So what you are wanted to show that is our A closure is nothing other than that this set B. That's what you are expecting. To prove that, a closure is basically, just you have shown that A union A dash. So you are tempted to show that A union A dash is B. So this is what you are trying to prove. So to prove that A union A dash is B, start with some member from left side. Y is an element in A union A dash. If Y is in A, then what it says? Either in A or in A dash. If Y is in A, then every neighborhood of Y definitely meets A. At least the point at Y. So Y should be in B. On the other hand, if Y is in A dash, by the definition of accumulation point, again it follows. So in both cases, that is A union A dash is going to be inside the condition, or it satisfies the condition B, which means A union A dash is part of B. Now what about the other side? Other side means start with a general point in Y, then what happens? So Y is in B. Y is in B means you take any neighborhood of Y that should intersect with A, non-trivial. Suppose your Y is not inside A union A dash, but A union A dash is A closure. Then Y should be in A closure complement, which implies what? X minus, see, A closure is closed, right? So X, A closure complement is open, so it's a neighborhood. So X minus A closure is an open set, so it's a neighborhood of Y. That is what it says. But X minus A closure is not going to touch A. Definitely A is sitting inside A closure, right? Away from that. Which so the contradiction actually says that it is not possible, and Y should be inside A union A closure. A dash. The equality holds, and for any subset A, A closure precisely consists of those points in X for which every neighborhood of Y meets A non-locally. So once again, what I wanted to stress is A closure consisting or is consist of all points near to A. Just basically that. It consists of all points near to A. But near to A, it is somewhat a vague concept, but in the metric space, this can be realized much better way. So suppose X is a metric space. The metric topology is in concern. Even a point Y you take and a set A, subset in the X, if you are looking at, you can actually define notion of nearness. I mean, D from the point A the set A can be very formally written as the infimum of all DXYs where Y is where X is inside A. You allow all X's to vary inside A, then just evaluate DXYs, go for the infimum, that is precisely gives the, in fact it is going to be the shortest distance of Y from the set A, that notion will come up, right? So in using this, one can actually show that A closure is nothing other than that set of all Y in X for which DYA is going to be zero. So very near to points, I mean all those points which are very near to A, maybe because of A is Y is inside, or maybe because of accumulation point, whatever it is. So once you are ready to define infimum of DXYs with X is varying inside this A, and formally define this as a nearness connection, that is Y a point with a subset, that is giving us some notion of A closure. Metric space, these things are very clear. But in general also, one can actually define nearness condition in a general topological space also with the formal way, because we have to give on the set the x as well as power set of x crossing, and you can formally define if you want. For the sake of completion, let me just define that what exactly it is, without much explanation and all. A relation, you can define it on a set as I mentioned, x cross p of x. It's obviously y is a point, it is very near to the empty set, and it's a relation kind of way. Your y is inside A, it's very near, it behaves with union, and these conditions actually are the properties with the definition satisfies, and city satisfies like that. But why nearness relation is important is that if you are ready to define the nearness relation like this, one can actually characterize topology using this nearness also. That is another advantage. Just for that also, I am noting it down. There is a one-to-one correspondence between the set of topologies on a set X and the set of nearness relations on that set. One can actually work with that and do that. But we will not spend much time on that, and we will simply go to the notion of boundaries. The nearing conditions actually gives that idea. A closure, we have seen something, and the points nearing to A, and maybe from the inside A, you can approach that point. Metric sense, it's very nice to look at. Easily one can digest it. But in general topological space also, A closure just means that. So what should be the boundary in fact? That also gives a notion out of that. That you will try to define like this. A may be any subset of a topological space X, and look at any subset A. What do you mean by the boundary is nothing other than that? You look at A closure, you look at A complement closure. So A closure, all the nearing points of A are concerned. If you are looking X minus A, I mean the complement part, this outside part, if you are looking at, its closure also will come. So what is common to them? That is what is precisely the boundary. The notion of boundary is nothing other than that. So it should be boundary of a set. Naturally it should be. It can be approachable from A as well as from outside of A. I mean the complement of A. So that idea is precisely the formal definition of boundary. So boundary of A, we will denote it as dou A. Dou A is by definition A closure intersection with X minus A whole closure. One can look at examples for all boundary of the set with nice subsets. For example, R you can consider, and one can check whether what about the boundary of Q. So you have to look for Q closure as well as Q complement closure. Are they coming something in between? Just think about that. So nice examples you can try it out. Obviously, if you are looking at boundaries, the usual notions are very much coinciding, because for the interval, for example, 1 to 3, if I am looking at in the real line with the usual topology, is if this is my set, I know obviously that the A closure is nothing other than the closed interval 1, 3, because the set with its accumulation points are going to come. That is A closure. If I am looking at A complement, what is going to happen is this open part will come. Its closure includes something like this. So the common part is again this point as well as this point, which says that 1 as 3 are going to be the boundary. So this kind of one can work with good examples other than this, obviously with as I mentioned, boundary of rationals, boundary of natural numbers, all such things you can check up. Various exercises one can do it. Now all these notions are the basic concept to understand topology and the nearness conditions. Why nearness and all these conditions are important? That we can check it. Because topology, whenever categorically if you are talking about, what we wanted to say is topological objects are topological spaces. From one topological space to another topological spaces, how will you move? So what are the structure preserving connections? They are functions, not merely functions. As I pointed out in the early stages, that you have to consider continuous functions. So how to define continuity in an abstract manner in a topological space? that comes into picture. So continuity can be defined, ideally it's going to be the nearness condition should be intact. So nearing points kept intact under that such maps, such functions, they are going to be called as appropriate morphisms or the continuous functions. So formal definitions should cast in a way like that. Now we'll try to look at how that definition can be done. That's also a better way of looking at it. So what we need the following. We have a topology. So the notion of continuity in a general setup you are trying to look at. You look at any topological space X2. And one can consider Y. With some topology, I may denote it as U. Now, a connection, naturally a function. F is from X to Y. I wanted to say that it is continuous. Obviously, continuity, the nearness conditions, all these kinds of things going to depend on tau as well as U. So what I am going to define it formally is in the following way. It's a local property. So what I am trying to look at is, I will just take any point x0 in x. I wanted to say that f is continuous at x0. Then I will go for the image f of x0, which is available in y. And formal definitions can be given in that way such that you, I may take a v, an open set in y. That is, v is available in u. Any v, I will take it from u, containing my point f of x0. And if I am able to find out an open set U that is available in 2, it is an open set in X containing that point X0 in such a way that this entire U under F is mapped inside B. That is, F of U is sitting inside B. That is the definition we are going to give for continuity. So, from a topological space X2 to a topological space yu, at a point x0, I wanted to say that f is continuous. Definition will be casted in the way that f is said to be continuous at x0, provided take any open set in y containing that f of x0. If you are able to find out a u open in x containing that x0, such that this f of u is sitting inside p. This is how the definition casts. Obviously, if you are working with metric spaces, X is a metric, Y is another metric, and our epsilon delta definition, if you are using, it actually coincides with this idea. So it subsumes. So this is the abstraction going to come in a general topological space. Now, this notion of continuity or keeping the nearing points nearing way with that x naught, it's not blasting it out, such ideas we can reformulate in many ways.